Don't make this mistake. Indeed. Hey there, I'm Tom Cheswick, and today I'm going to save your soul from the Photoshop gods. Command-Shift-U in Photoshop, otherwise known as desaturation, is one of the worst ways to make a black and white. Today I'm going to show you three ways to make exceptional black and white portraits using ON1 Photo Raw. Let's take this image, hit the D key, and it opens up and develop. So what is desaturation? Besides being the worst way to make a black and white image, in Photoshop you would do Command-Shift-U. In ON1, you would go down to color and take saturation and make a black and white image. Gives you no control and it doesn't really do a great job. So what are some better ways to do this? Well, let's reset everything. Take this image into effects, add a filter, and select black and white. So we had, let's just turn this off for a moment, a green background, a blue jersey, and skin tone. There's three different colors. We could take that green and make it darker or brighter, depending on what we want to do. We have creative control. So let's bring that down just a touch and let's see how that looks. Remember, we also have the blue jersey. We could brighten that up. We could darken down that, but notice how it's just affecting the blue color. So if we wanted to darken a sky, we have complete control over a blue sky. There's even another way that you can adjust the colors on the image. You can come down to the eyedropper tool and then go onto your image, select, say, the skin tone, and we can brighten it or darken it. And it automatically finds the color and adjusts it for you. Now we're getting more and more control over the black and white conversion process. Even more, we can go into tone, we can adjust the blacks. Let's do Option or Alt J. And now we can see our black and white points. So if we start clipping anything, it will show up. So for example, with the blacks, we can deepen them. Now we're building contrast into our black and white. And we see we're just starting to clip. We could brighten our whites as well. Now we have a really nice black and white conversion, which is so much better than where we started at. And that's just one of the three methods. Let's take that, go back into Browse, and we'll work on a different way to convert. Let's create a version here. Let's reset that. Next, let's use a preset. Let's look at the different presets by doing Command or Control and left arrow. Let's look at the alternative. Okay, we could stretch this out a little bit to make it a little easier to see. If we hover over any of the images, it's going to give us a quick preview of what that looks like. Okay, so there are quite a few different ones that you could play with. None of them are catching my attention for this particular image. But let's look at Faded Matte. Definitely some nice ones there. Let's go back, black and white modern. Just like that, one click and you have a magnificent black and white image. That one looks stunning. Let's just apply that so you can see what it actually does. So if we now go into the effects, it's going to show us what filters it used to make that look, and it added three different ones. So there is a vignette, there is a glow, and then it also did a black and white conversion. If we click on the title of it, it will show us exactly what we did. So it increased the reds in the yellows, so that's brightening the skin tones. It did darken the blue, not necessarily because it knew what she had on. I think it's just part of the preset. Also, the green was minimized as well. Another group of presets that I love for the black and whites is the black and white films. And again, let's make this a little bit larger so you can really see what those are. The Delta 400, nice. Ilford FP4 125. A lot of great film looks. So one click and we can have Kodak Tri-X 400. And again, let's see what that added. And this one has a tone enhancer. So pop the contrast quite a bit. It also did a black and white conversion. A custom toner. And also added the film grain into the image. Let's just look at a higher ISO film grain so you can see what that looks like watching the video. So we'll go to 3200 and you can see the grain texture a lot more. And then you have control over those as well, so you can minimize them or increase them in strength as well. Very nice way to do black and white conversions. Again, that's using the presets. Command left arrow takes away the presets. Last one we're going to do is one of the quickest ways to get killer results with black and white conversions. So if you really need to save time and you're looking for something that's really going to make your image pop, this is a great method. First, we're going to reset. So we'll cancel out of here. We'll open it up one more time. And we'll go into effects. Shortcut is letter S. And this time we're going to go add a filter. We're going to use LUTs. ON1 has some great LUTs just for black and white. So if we go down to the category where it says color pop, let's choose black and white. And boom, right off the bat, that's an amazing black and white image with the contrast, lots of pop, and brighten the skin. This is a great one for portraits. But if we go to the LUT, we can scroll through the different ones. If you want to ever compare two, just highlight one, move the mouse over, and go back to one so you can see. And see what they're doing. Another nice one, Pyro. So a very quick and easy way to make a black and white conversion. And even with the LUT applied, you can always add film grain. I think this is one of the quickest ways to make an exceptional black and white portrait using ON1 Photo Raw and LUTs. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this video and had a little fun. I know I did. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch my videos, and I hope you're getting something out of it. I know I'm doing it to help photographers grow and learn, and I want to help you succeed as a photographer. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. I'm trying to grow the channel, so please recommend this to your friends. Be sure to give it a like if you enjoyed the video, and consider subscribing so you're notified of the next video. All the best. Have a great day.